Hello to the pessimistic, optimistic, and everyone in between. My name is Connor Philby. Welcome back to the Minnesota Sports Podcast. And before I say anything else, just apologies, I do have a little bit of a cold, so I'm not sounding the best right now. But news just broke while I was at work today, and I had to just give my first, you know, raw reaction to signing. TJ Hockenson staying with the Vikings for 4 more years, a 4-year extension. 4 years, $68 million was the final cost of TJ Hockenson. And first of all, I'm very excited about this. Obviously, we're going to go a little bit into the risks and everything with TJ Hockenson and all of that, but this is something that the Vikings needed to do. He clearly came in after the trade last year and just really showed out. He is a very important part of our offense, especially in the red zone. He proved that later on in the year. He proved how much of a red zone target he is. I truly believe next year he has the potential to get up to 1,000 yards this upcoming season. And even if he doesn't, he will most likely, you know, be that short yardage guy in third down situations. It's unclear whether his role is going to change now that Addison's in instead of Thielen, because Thielen was, you know, a pure like slot receiver. Addison might be able to go more for deep shots, and that might cause Hockenson to be relied upon to, you know, get some of those shallower third and five type situations, and also his typical goal line situations. But either way, he's a pivotal piece of this Vikings offense, and locking him down for 4 years is a huge move for us. Obviously, there are downsides of it, or at least concerns or risks. One of those being he does have an injury history, and so that is going to be a factor. And dedicating that much money to a guy that has had an injury history is a little bit of concern. But honestly, he didn't miss that much time last year, considering people saying he's a constant injury threat. Like, he missed a couple games, but it wasn't that big of a deal. I don't see any of his injuries as being like long-term threats to like his health in the future. They're just kind of ways he kind of gets dinged up, and that it will happen to tight ends sometimes. So I don't know if that's a big enough risk for us to not pull the trigger on making this move. And also people saying that this was an overpay, and that making TJ Hockenson the highest paid tight end in the league was some like awful decision. But people need to remember, it's not like 3 years from now TJ Hockenson is not going to be the top paid tight end. Like, if the Vikings thought that the tight end market was going to stay this way for the next 5 years, they wouldn't make this decision. But clearly, when George Kittle gets another extension, he's going to get paid big time, definitely more than Hockenson's getting right now. Same thing with Kelsey. I'm sure Mark Andrews is going to get a huge payday when he is due for another extension. The tight end market was going to be reset and was going to inflate very soon anyway. The Vikings were just getting ahead of it. Clearly, if the Vikings thought, okay, this is the way that the market's going to be for a while, they're not going to dump that much money TJ Hockenson's way. But clearly, this is going to become the new standard for tight ends. It happened with wide receivers the last couple years. It's going to happen with tight ends. The Vikings were just the first to make the move that would reset that market. So TJ Hockenson, it was not an overpay. It was simply thinking ahead to the next step and what the next few years are going to be like for tight end deals. But those are my thoughts. Very excited about the TJ Hockenson signing. Now lock in Justin Jefferson, whether it's this offseason or next offseason. Make this offense volatile for the next however many years. If a new quarterback comes in the next few years, it's going to be huge to have those guys to, you know, get that quarterback off to a good start and to keep our offense, you know, consistent and make sure that we're continuing to not rebuild but to reload. So great signing. I love it. Let me know what you think in the comments. But anyway, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you on the flip side.